It has become a wonderful tradition at the end of each year. Viewers like you helping WGN-TV Family Charities and the Robert R. McCormick Foundation collect meals, money, and toys for local organizations trying to make a difference in our communities. Joining us now, Tammy Pierce with Habitat for Humanity, Chicago Board President Larry Huggins, Christmas in the Ward's founder, Cameron Mattson, she's with the Greater Chicago Food Depository, and Arnett Morris, of course, is with such a great organization out there from Off the Street Club, and he has a guest with us today. So hello, everybody. Glad to have you here. Tell us a little bit. Let's start with you. Tell us a little bit about your organization. People really recognize the name Habitat for Humanity, but let's get in the weeds. What do you guys do?
Yeah, so at Habitat, we really believe that everybody deserves a decent place to live. So we really champion healthy and thriving neighborhoods by supporting affordable home ownership. We're currently in three areas of Chicago. We're in West Pullman, Greater Grand Crossing, and Austin. And at the end of last year, we just completed our 28th home on the south block of 119th
Congratulations.
Street.
That is such an impressive figure. And part of the deal, if I recall correctly, is that people have to work, put in some sweat equity on the home that they're eventually going to take possession of.
Absolutely. They're out on the site building each other's homes, their neighbors' homes. They're going through our home buyer university. By the time they move in, they will know integrally every single part of that home, be able to care for it, and the neighborhoods will thrive.
Pride in home ownership,
absolutely,
for sure. Larry, nice to see you again.
Oh, happy to be here.
Great suit, by the way.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about your organization.
Well, Christmas in the Wards is an organization that was started 27 years ago in Inglewood. And the purpose of that is about Christmas toys for needy families, in other words, would not have a Christmas. And over those 27 years, we have now made Christmas possible for 19,000 families. And we are now in 40 of the 50 wards, and our goal is to be in all 50 wards.
And it's encompassing, it's year-round activities now, right? You're engaging in year-round. It's not just during the holidays.
That is correct. You know, as a matter of fact, we got three events that we're going to be doing this year. Well, our goals in May, we're going to give away over 200 laptops.
That's great.
We're planning another big event in October, and it leads up to Christmas, which this year is going to be back at McCormick.
You're still teaching the kids how to do cursive writing, right?
Absolutely.
You had a little story on that earlier. Yeah. Thank you so much. If we could talk about the Greater Chicago Food Depository, it's one of the things that we do here at Channel 9. We have a food drive for your organization, and so many people respond positively to that. So, Cameron, tell us a little bit about what you do year round.
Well, thanks to wonderful donors and volunteers like you guys, the Greater Chicago Food Depository is the food bank for Chicago. And so we're at the center of a network of more than 800 food pantries, soup kitchens, shelters, and other meal programs. So we provide them food, and we're just so grateful to be able to help meet the huge need throughout Chicago and Cook County.
Food insecurity is a huge deal for so many people out there. So many people are only a couple of paychecks away for being destitute.
Yes.
So you help fill those gaps.
Yeah, one in five families, households throughout Chicago is food insecure. When you talk about families with children, it is one in four. So those numbers are difficult, but we all work together. We're on this mission to end hunger, and we can make a dent.
And do it in a dietary and nutritious way.
Of course. Like you were saying, everyone deserves good housing. Everyone deserves healthy food. That's what we're there for.
Arnett, nice to see you again.
And you
brought
Patrick
a guest,
Bob
Patrice.
Yeah, Miss Patrice.
Yes. She's the second in charge there,
everyone.
I believe. longest running, serving inner city organization, Off the Street Club. So many people know what you do, but in your words, tell us a little bit about it.
First, thank you, Patrick, for having us here again today. I have to say thank you to our board member, Paul Rennie, because he's right there in the room. Can't leave him out. But Off the Street Club, as you said, is Chicago's oldest club for boys and girls. We've been around for 123 years. We're an after-school community. We serve about 250 kids per day, about 2,500 per year. Our goal is very simple, to provide a safe place for kids after school in a very challenging community. We have a whole host of programs, from performing arts, athletics, a girls center, skating rink, performing arts, arts and crafts. But the most important program, Larry, is an intangible one, and it's all about character building. Mm-hmm. You want to build young people who have strong character, because as Frederick Douglass said, it's easier to build strong children than to fix broken men. And collectively, I believe we're all doing just that on this panel today.
Truer words were never spoken.
Yeah.
And you also make a point of hooking these kids up with some mentors.
Absolutely. Ms. Patrice?
Absolutely. Well, mentors and volunteers is what we're all about. We thrive with our volunteers. So they take the time out to come and see what Off the Street Club is all about. And we love the children, and the children is what we're there for. So our volunteers, they come, they lead great lives like everyone up here, and they tell the kids, you can do this, you can make it, you can finish school, you can become a stand-up member in society. I was one of those children. So now here it has become my conviction now to go back and mentor these children, the young girls who need us, also, you know, young boys as well. They're the highest risk in Chicago. So we want to make sure that they not only have somewhere to go and play, but what about their future? What's going to come behind this? So we want to make sure that they know about owning a home and, you know, giving back and volunteering, mm-hmm. things like that. So we thrive and we strive with our volunteers and our mentorship.
I know you share this. When I talk to kids throughout the city, I tell them, you know, only the only person that can tell you no is you.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And one of our mottos is if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. So we want the kids to believe in themselves, first of all, and also know that they can do great things through Off the Street Club and through our donors and people like WGN who continue to put us on the map and put us out there.
Well, we are so proud to be partners with you all. And this, the dollars and cents of what today is all about. So let's get to it. So we have a check presentation right now. And let's begin with you. $122,600. That's a whopping amount of money right there.
Yes.
But again, you had match funds and it makes such a difference. What are you going to do with that money? To state the obvious.
So this money will go directly to helping U.S. veterans, military service members and their families move into home ownership, take control, have a thriving neighborhood. We just launched a very exciting 5-year strategic plan where we will be this year building and renovating 100 homes and preserving 300 others through our neighborhood grants.
That is fantastic. And home ownership pays so many dividends.
Absolutely. Right. It's generational. Mm-hmm. We've seen children who are doing poor in school, they get into a home, have that stability, and they're excelling.
That is so great to hear. Larry, tell us a little bit what you're going to do with that money.
Well, actually, Christmas and Awards this year is going to provide anywhere between 500 to 1,000 laptops to Chicago public school students. Because mm-hmm. one of the things that we know is that the importance for kids to learn, they need those laptops
gotta
as a tool. They
got
to have
sure.
it. So.
Yeah.
In May, we're going to have an event where we're going to give away about 200 laptops.
Well, we will be there for sure to cover that.
Absolutely.
Cameron, tell us a little bit of what you're going to do about that money, feeding people.
This translates to meals on tables for families who didn't know where that meal was going to come from. So thank you. This is vital.
Quick dollar amount, how much money goes towards one meal? What would $5 get you?
$1 does about the equivalent of 3 meals. So.
It's a lot of eating going on right now. That's a lot of cabbage going on there.
For a lot of people, and we're so grateful. Thank
you
so much.
We're so happy for you. And Arnett and Patrice, you have the final words.
Well, these funds will go toward our performing arts program, where we teach our kids how to sing, travel all around the country. We went to New York, Philadelphia for our 20th anniversary. We want to bring our music to America. And also, we have a Jazz Masters Workshop program where we teach kids bass guitar, lead guitar,
right,
drums, keyboard, and vocals. So
music is the gift of life.
It's the window to the soul.
We thank you so much. You mentioned Paul Rennie. He's our general manager and VP here at WGN. And if you ask me, he is the gold standard. You can find information on each of these organizations on social media. The website's listed on your screen, which you can also find at WGNTV.com. Congratulations, one and all.
Thank you.
Thank you.